Dear students, I am Santan, working as a physics faculty in Target English Medium School. Today, in this fourth video, I would like to teach what are the musical instruments and how many types are there, how they produce the sound. The topics we discussed in this fourth video from the chapter of sound. So in our previous video, in the same chapter, we clearly discussing about how does sound travels through the air, and after that we discussed it. Does sound has energy or not? The two concepts we clearly discussing in our previous video. Now our topic is musical instruments. Musical instruments. So generally in our daily life we are observing that during the marriage function or is any concert conducted by the music directors is nothing but musician, and in certain TV programs also we are observing that different types of instruments are played by the various persons. So means like tabla, mridanga, violin, guitar, veena, clarinet, flute, shahanai, drums, like this all the harmonium, this type of instruments they are playing during the producing the sound. Anyway, so when they are play the particular instrument, it produce the sound. So really how they produce the sound, that is we discussed that in what type of way. So that is we discussed under the topic of types of musical instrument. So many types of musical instruments are there. So many musical instruments are there in the nature. That musical instrument further we are classified into the three types mainly. The first one is air or wind instruments. Second one, string instruments. Third one, membrane instruments. So mainly the musical instruments can be classified into the three types: air or wind instruments, string instrument, and third one is the membrane instrument. And another special instruments are there, that is the percussion instrument. That is later I will explain after completion of this one. Now we discuss it step by step. So our first one is air wind instruments. Air or wind instrument is nothing but mainly in the musical instrument, air or wind during the blowing of air through it is play an important role to produce the sound. That's why the instruments we are called air or wind instrument. Simply the sound produced by the blowing of air into it, that instruments we are called air or wind instrument. Listen very carefully. The instruments which are produce the sound like by blowing air in it, the instrument which are produce the sound by blowing the air in it, that instruments we are called air or wind instrument. For example, flute, clarinet, shahnai, etc. are the best example for the air or wind instrument. In the flute, okay, number of narrow holes are there. By blowing the air and tap the our fingers on their holes, what will happen? It produces the sound. Clarinet is also there, okay, like this one. So that in the clarinet also, by blowing the air, what will happen? It produces the sound. Shahnai, Bismillah Khan is the famous, okay, in this musical instrument. So shahnai, shahnai means mostly in the marriages. You are observing that a long, okay, one end is narrow, another one is a large hole is there. So by tapping on that one, their holes. So when you can blow the air in it, it produces a huge sound. Anyway, you are observing that in case of flute, in case of clarinet, or in case of shahnai. Okay, by blowing the air in it, they produce the sound. That's why the sound, the instrument which are produce the sound by blowing the air in it, that instruments we are called air or wind musical instrument. So examples are flute, clarinet, shahnai, etc. Second one is string musical instrument. Are string instruments simply string musical instrument or string instruments? So in the air or wind instrument, which is played important main key role, air or blowing wind. But here, which one string is play an important role to produce the sound? So mostly you are observing that guitar, veena, violin, etc. We are observing that. So, the instrument which are produce the sound by a string. Listen very carefully. The instrument which are produce the sound by the string, that instruments we are called string instrument. Listen. The instrument which are produce the sound by plug the string, that instruments we are called string instrument. In case of guitar, veena, violin, we are observing that. In a guitar, so, okay, strings are connected with a particular tension, in the veena also and also violin. So any one of the musical instrument is in your hand, just you can set that. So after that one, initially the all the strings are in a rest position. Now, with help of your finger or by using a small tiny object, just you can tap on the string. The string is start the vibration and produce the sound. That's why, so means the instrument which will produce the sound by the string, when you can tap, when you can apply the force on it, that instruments we are called string instrument, guitar, veena, violin. These are the best examples for the which instrument, string instruments. Third one is membrane instrument. Membrane instruments. So membrane instrument means here air or wind in the string instrument, string is play an important role. Here which one? Membrane. So you are observing the tabla. Tappeta, mridangam, etc. We are observing that. So means in case of tabla or tappeta or mridangam, so mostly you are observing tabla, everyone will be seeing tabla and tappeta. So in one side you are observing that where you can tap, okay, one layer is there. Generally, in the olden days, it is made up of the animal skin, but in the modern days, we are made with the plastic also. So now, you are observing that, so a layer is there. That layer we are called as a membrane. On the layer, when you can tap with the help of our fingers, so then what will happen? They produce the sound. That's why the instruments which are produce the sound through the membrane, are by the membrane. the instruments which are produce the sound by the membrane, that instruments we are called membrane instrument. Tabla, tappeta, prudangam, etc. Prudangam means on both sides. Tappeta means only one side, and tabla is, we know that. That's why. So mainly the musical instruments are classified into the how many types in our surrounding? Mainly three types. A are wind instrument. Second one is the string instrument. Third one is the membrane instrument. The instrument which are produce the sound by blowing the air in it, that instruments we are called A or wind instrument. For example, flute, clarinet, shahanai, etc. Second one, the instruments which are produce the sound by the string, that instruments we are called string instrument, guitar, veena, violin, etc. Third one, membrane instrument, the instruments which are produce the sound by the membrane, that instrument is called membrane instrument. For example, tabla, tappeta, mrudangam, etc. So these are the types of musical instrument. And one special case is also there here, that is also we discussed that. It is a special category. That is the percussion instrument. Percussion instrument. Percussion instrument instruments is nothing but the sound is coming from a group of instruments. Listen carefully. So the sound is coming from a group of instrument, that is called percussion sound. Is nothing but sorry. Okay. The group of all instruments produce the sound, that instruments we are called percussion instrument. So mostly you are observing that Sivamani. Okay, Sivamani is one of the famous in the drum player. But you are observing that when he plays the drums, not only the drums, different instruments are there. Means he will play the simultaneously the number of instruments fastly. So that's why you are observing that. So one side is a drum, one side is like iron plate, like steel plate, like is there. One side is tabla, like that number of are there. That's why the sound is coming from at a time from the group of instrument. The sound is coming from a group of instrument that is called, what is that word? Percussion instrument. So in this video we clearly discussing that. What is our topic? Our topic name is musical instrument. So in our surrounding area, in our surrounding, in our daily life, we see the number of musical instrument like harmonium, tabla, tappeta, mrudangam, flute, clarinet, shahanai, like this type of one. But the musical instrument further classified into the three types based on the producing of the sound, means based on the part of the sound produced by it. So how many types? Means mainly three types: air or wind instrument, second one is string instrument, and third one is the membrane instrument. And percussion instrument is the special category. The sound is coming from a group of instrument that is called percussion instruments of the sound. Next one is the sound produced by the human beings. Sound produced by the human beings. So means generally you have some idea, is it? So in our daily life, in the nature, we are observing the birds, animals, they produce the sound. Like the same way, human also you are observing that. So mainly in case of human being, the humans are produce the different types of sound. But the birds or animals are produced, their species will produce only one type of sound, but in case of human being, we can produce the different types of sounds during in our conversation with other peoples. But okay, how the sound is produced by the human being, mainly we discussing that. So generally we know that okay, how many sense organs are there? 5 are there, we know that. So each sense organ will be play one important role in a particular. For example, eye is for the vision, ear is for hearing, tongue is for taste, okay, the skin is to, okay, so for touch. So means like the same way you are observing that in case of human being, how the sound is produced means one special organ is there, that organ name is larynx. Larynx. So larynx is an important organ in the human body. It is produce the sound in human being. Listen very carefully. Larynx is an important organ in the human body, to produce the sound. So the larynx is just like it acts as a windpipe, like windpipe. Here is the, this one is the windpipe. In the windpipe, so one small narrow hole is there. This is called, what is that one? This is the larynx. It is called vocal box. In the vocal box, so it is the vocal cords. Larynx is an important organ in the human body to produce the sound. So the larynx will be mainly contain two muscular ligaments. The two muscular ligaments we are called vocal cords. These are the one. Okay. These vocal cords are okay. Where located means these vocal cords are in vocal box. These vocal cords are initially, they are okay, appears like a stretched membrane and having a narrow slit between them. Listen very carefully. Larynx is an important organ in the human body because it produces a sound. So the larynx will be having mainly two muscular ligaments. They are called vocal cords or vocal boxes. Okay. So that's why these vocal cords are there. These vocal cords will be mainly okay in located or mainly in the vocal box component. Here is there, and it will be hanging. Okay, so the vocal box, sorry, larynx is important organ in the human body. It will be contain mainly two muscular ligaments. They are called vocal box. The vocal box will be having mainly the stretched membrane that is called vocal cords. The vocal cords will be have a narrow slit on its middle. When during the speaking with any other one, the slit will be open and allow the air into the lungs. When you can try to speak with other persons, the vocal cords are will be closed, means the slit will be closed. And okay, so when the air will be coming from our mouth, okay, from the lungs, it will be press the which one? Vocal cords, then vocal cords will be start the vibration and produce the okay regarding sound to the outside. So that's why larynx will be play an important role for the producing of the human body. So it is the simplest topic. One second reason, larynx is an important organ in the human body to produce the sound. It will be have two muscular ligaments are called vocal cords. It will be okay, the vocal cords are in the part of vocal box. So the vocal cords are appears as a stretched membrane like layer. It will be having a narrow slit. When a person is trying to speak with the other one, the vocal boxes are closed and they so start the vibration by passing the air through it and producing the sound. When okay, during the breathing, the vocal cords will be open and allow the air into the lungs. That's why. So you are not doing the two things at a time. It's nothing but okay. A man cannot do the speaking and breathing at a time. It is not possible because of when you can try to breathe at that time, the slit will be open and allow the air. When you can try to speak, the slit will be closed and the pressure air will be touched to the vocal cords, start the vibration and produce the sound outside. That's why we cannot perform the two activities at a time. We can perform only one activity at the time. And in this one, which are the main important thing means the length of the vocal cords. The length of the vocal cords or vocal boxes in men nearly 20 millimeters. In the women mainly it is 15 millimeter. In children's mainly it is 6 millimeter or 6 to 10 millimeter. That is okay. So in case of men, what is the length of the vocal cords? 20 millimeter. In case of women, it is the 15 millimeter. In the children's are nearly 6 to 10 millimeters are there. This is the range of the vocal cords. That's why. So the length of the vocal cords is very high in the men and women is less. How much one? 5 millimeter is less for the women. That's why women are produce the high pitched sound and men are produce the loud sound during the conversation.